you get a line, I'll get a pole, honey. Honey, you get a line and I'll get a pole, baby. You get a line and I'll get a pole, we'll all go down to the cold dead hole, honey. Baby, mine.
Today we're going to visit Bill Connor, who's one of the last true river rats on the Delta.
Bill Connor. I was born in 1931 in Phoenix, Arizona. Lived in Arizona for just a short time. Lived in California most of my life. Lived in Stockton even, well, most of my life. As a kid, I built rafts and rafted the Delta in the summertime. Swam in the Calaveras Canal in the winter and summer. Like I say, I've lived here probably 76 or 78 years I've been alive. I went to school, most of the schools in Stockton. Lived about a year and a half in Indiana with my great-grandparents. And went to Jackson School, Woodrow Wilson School in Stockton, Stockton High School. Was a shoe salesman, worked in restaurants. Joined the Marine Corps, 51, during the Korean War. Got out, got married to my wife, Georgia, died. We had two children, Eric and Cindy. And then I was a salesman for Ross and Drug and Sundry Company, warehouseman and salesman, and worked for Thomas J. Lipton as a sales representative. Got a chance to buy Lost Isle, so the wife and I and the kids moved out to Lost Isle and started running it.
Here's Lost Isle Harbor in 1973 when Bill and Georgia Connor operated it.
It's an annual Labor Day event, and Lost Isle is the only place to have it.
Lost Isle is beautiful. I mean, we've got palm trees, we've got beautiful women. Everybody's nice.
We come out here about the last 3 years, and it is so much fun. We really haven't found a better place to come. Give me that stuff, that funk, that sweet, that funk is stuff. Give it to me. Give me that stuff, that funk, that sweet, that funk is stuff. Give it to me, give it to me. Give it to me, give it to me. Give me the stuff.
Beers are flowing, I hear the Mai Tais are good. Boats are around the clock coming in.
There ain't nowhere else you can be on Labor Day.
Where you've heard about love and giving sight to the blind. My baby loving cause the sun to shine. And she must be a little thing.
moved out to Lost Isle in 1966, and then in 1980, well, then we sold it, and the wife got rid of me.
What was it like for a family living on the island when Connor's owned Lost Isle?
My name is Georgia Connor, and I live in Stockton now, and I remember the days on Lost Isle. And our first day out there, I remember stopping at a grocery store and buying, the place had been closed for quite a long time, and I bought a couple packages of hot dogs and buns and hamburgers and buns and potato chips, and that's how we got started with the food, and then it just increased and increased, and it gradually got to the point where our meat man said that we sold more meat than anyone in Stockton, and that's when we got into the steaks and all that. But and my children, Cindy was in the second grade. My son Eric was in kindergarten, but they didn't have kindergarten out at Holt School, so he stayed with us on the island until the next year, and then he got to go to on school. And they turned out to be really good kids. They worked real hard for us. Helped us out. My daughter would help me in the mornings for breakfast. My son would come in at noon, and I would take off for a couple hours, and he'd take over the hamburger crowd.
And my name is Cindy Connor Ray. I grew up on Lost Isle. My parents are Bill and Georgia Connor. I got married in 1981 to David Ray, and he works in Stockton at Williams Tank Lines. We live in Lake Comanche, which is east of Lodi, California. I work at Ion Elementary School in the office as the attendance clerk. And I have two children, Daniel and Brenna, 25 and 22, and they live in Utah right now. And I have a granddaughter on the way from my son and my daughter-in-law, Mary. Growing up on Lost Isle was interesting and fun and exciting and sometimes boring. Boring because in the winter there was nobody there except for my mom, my dad, my brother, and whatever employees were there at the time. I had lots of fun during the summer. I started working there in the restaurant when I was probably about 10 or 12 years old. I helped my mom cook in the mornings, and I just worked in the mornings and had the rest of the afternoon off, so that was great. My brother had the bad shift, that was the afternoon shift, and he was a good afternoon cook. My mom, of course, worked the evening shift, and we helped her out when she had big dinners and stuff to do. It was fun because a lot of kids would wonder where I lived, and they, in high school, they said I lived on Gilligan's Island, which sometimes was true. It was kind of crazy, but it was fun to have friends come out and visit, and they would enjoy seeing where I lived. They were very interested because I had to take a boat to school. My brother and I would get in a boat and drive out of the harbor and go to a friend's house where we caught the bus. I learned a lot. I sometimes think I might have grown up pretty fast, but other times I felt like I lived in Mayberry because it was very different. And the people were fun and interesting to get to know. I met a lot of people that would come in on boats. There was different friends that would come out to see us that would come out every summer and visit. And so we got to know people that just made it a kind of their vacation spot. In the summertime, it was lots of fun. We'd meet people that I'd end up becoming pen pals with. And by pen pals, I mean pen pals. We wrote letters back and forth and had a great relationship that way. So I always stayed connected with certain people that would come out and visit, and we'd reacquaint in the summer, and have just lots of fun at night playing with kids our own age. There was a lot of families that would come out and camp and boat, and they would stay sometimes for 3 or 4 days. So we would have a lot of fun in the summer being able to be with these kids, and we'd swim at night at the beach and watch movies. My dad would have a video projector set up and a big white screen, I think it was made out of plywood, and watch movies outside. They'd show certain movies, and so kids would have a ball just being outside at night, and you didn't have to worry about anything. You're on an island, so it made it fun and safe, and different activities. On 4th of July, we had the greatest fireworks in the world, and people would tell you that. It was just really wonderful. They'd fire them off over the water, and so there was a lot for kids to do, and we'd have fun just hanging out. It was an exciting life, and I wouldn't really change any of it. I am glad that I had that experience. Nobody else really has that kind of experience, and so it was a great opportunity.
I met a lot of nice, really nice people out there, and there's still a couple that are still close friends of mine. Their names, well, they were in the Super Secret Ship Club, and there's Crazy Chris. There were no dues or anything. They didn't have meetings or anything. It was just they all gathered out at the island and partied. But I was going to say this, Crazy Chris, I'm still in touch with her, and Fancy Phyllis. And I was one of the lucky ones. They gave me a good name of Georgia Peach, because there were some pretty crazy names given out to some of the people. So I felt pretty lucky. And there were a lot of nice people.
Wasn't Hal Schell a member of that too?
Oh yeah, he's the one I think that got it started. Wasn't he the one?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he started. They got it started, and it really, I still have my jacket. Everybody had purple jackets. And all it was a big party thing. In fact,
that's where it got its name, because it was so good. We had people from all over the world coming to Lost Isle. At the time, rental houseboats was the big thing on the Delta, and so people from France, Germany, Southern California, all over, would rent houseboats and come out, and most of the marinas didn't really care for houseboats because they said all they wanted was information, place to empty their garbage and get water, and I felt they needed recreation. So Lost Isle became the popular place for houseboating on the Delta, to the point where the houseboat companies would just simply say, you know, here's the key, this is the way you steer it, this is the way you do it, and here's the way you get to Lost Isle. It was very good for them, because if in those days sometimes the houseboats broke down. And if they broke down and Lost Isle, well, then they had food and recreation and everything, and they didn't. There wasn't really that much of a hurry to get going again. We had, of course, volleyball, horseshoes, pinballs was big at that time. Pinball machines. We had, of course, people were danced. Had the big swim beach. We had a lot of animals. We had sheep, goats, peacocks, monkeys, burros, ponies, guinea hens, rabbits. Just about all kind of animals just running around loose, causing trouble. And then the kids moved to town, of course, when they went to high school, and the wife went too. So then some people come by and said they wanted to buy it, so we sold it, and the wife moved to town, and left me out here to suffer. So, here I suffer. What happened to Lost Isle, and is happening to every business, in the 70s, when Jerry Brown became governor, well then, literally, if you picked up a 16-penny nail and a hammer, you had 32 agencies to go through to pound that 16-penny nail in the wood. And because of that, you couldn't get anything done if you had a business, and businesses do that now. The water problem that the farmers have down in Fresno is that same agencies, only there's even more than 32 agencies. And it's tough being in business. In the old days, you'd go down to the county and Board of Health, the building inspector, city council, the county board of supervisors or something like that, maybe get a permit. But then when Jerry Brown came in, well, it was 32 agencies. When we left Lost Isle, it was pretty well family oriented, and boating is family oriented. You can buy a tennis racket and a ball, or you can buy a set of golf clubs and do it on your own as a family. But when you get into boating, you've got to have wherewithal. In addition to that, you've got to include the family with you, because it's a good piece of the income that's coming out of your thing. And I think what happened was Lost Isle, it was risque, knitted bathing suits and stuff like that, and people climbing the trees. You had to find the right people for the right houseboat the next morning to make sure that everything was okay. But and people drinking and hanging from the trees and things like that. But then they kind of turned it into a t-shirt contest, and you just had to take your t-shirt off to win any prizes. And after a while, it got where you practically had to get naked. They were responsible little kids from San Jose and Fremont and South San Francisco, that went down and rented a houseboat, and they had maybe a ski boat tied behind it, and they had their boom box on the houseboat, and these little girls, they could wear bun floss, it fit them well. And the kids were pretty well buffed out and scared people, but the kids basically were regular people just trying to get a cheap Hawaiian vacation.
Good old nice weather, sun, and it's beautiful.
3 days, man, 3 days of this. Can't beat it, just can't beat it. Come here because there's hella girls and it's fun. Because people pull out, my friends pull out my.
My girlfriend's at home this afternoon. She'll be here with me tomorrow.
My friends pull out my pants.
So today I'm out here having a good time with all the girls.
Labor Day weekend, awesome. You gotta chill off. Back. A lot of women, my dude. You better be here. Yeah, Lost Isle.
Get lost at Lost Isle.
You talk to anybody else about from anywhere other than the Delta, and they say you tell them you're from the Delta, and they go, oh, Lost Isle, we know exactly where that is. Everybody knows Lost Isle. They think this is like the heart of the Delta.
barge is, it's called the Uncle Sam. It was built in 1903. It was a wood dredge for dredging the clamshell dredge for dredging the river. It's the last remaining wooden steam-driven clamshell dredge that's still visible. All the rest of them are in the Tules and Made Islands. And this is kind of my garden and place to sit and visit. And play music. I do things like that. This is, I have five of these benches. I belong to Universal Life Church in Modesto. I do weddings and funerals. And years ago, the Reverend Hensley came out to Lost Isle, and I had a building. It was a house of the future in a 1939 World's Fair at Treasure Island that I got from Gardera, and I put out at Lost Isle. And the Reverend Hensley came out to Lost Isle and on Easter and performed a wedding and dedicated the House of the Future as a Universal Life Church and Wedding Chapel. And at the time, he gave me these benches, and these are the original benches from the Universal Life Church in Modesto. And he gave me five of them. So what I do, most of the wood and stuff like that, it comes from wood I just pulled out of the Delta. The thatch comes from a palm tree. Most everything has been just kind of gathered over the years. And the decking, I had to redeck it because the old deck was pretty well worn out. Let's see. These I got from Tower Park. They had them there, and I asked them if I could have a plant, and I took a couple of them, and now I give them to different people, but they really grow well. And I have blueberries that came up wild on the Delta, and I get here on the barge, and I get a lot of these blueberries.
Bill, 78 at the time of this interview, talks about his health while living on his Uncle Sam barge houseboat.
I try to stay with vegetables and protein, meat and vegetables. I had a hip replacement. I thought it was just a groin pull. That's what all the doctors said on the Delta, you know, these fake doctors, you know, that knew. But anyway, they kept saying, you know, put a cold compress on it, put a warm compress on it. I had everything. Finally, I damn near died. And they found out that my hip was completely gone. So other than that, I've been pretty healthy. Because you can't live out here with bad health. You know, if I ever got, that's why I try to keep myself in pretty good shape, is because you couldn't live out here if you weren't.
So what is this island called, or your designated area here? Does it have a name?
No, some people call it Connor's Court for kind of a tongue-in-cheek. Because you're sitting on the bottom, but and my phone number is 209-482-2274, which is 48 to barge. You know, I had so she's referred to the barge. It's my address. It's just via river out, Stockton 95219. Like I say, originally the barge was called the Uncle Sam. The mailman knows everybody on the Delta. And when I had Lost Isle, well then, that too was the river mailman. So if somebody ever wrote to wanted to write my daughter or my son, then all I had to say was just like, Eric, on the river, Stockton, California. And the mail would go to Stockton, California, and they'd know, you know, that the mailman, and of course the mailman knew everybody, so you had a stamp. Well, then Louie or Rick or somebody would deliver the mail.
Well, show me your actual living quarters, Bill.
Sure. I have, like I say, tool sheds and everything. I have a solar panel there for charging a car battery for my radio. My television doesn't work because I don't think those new boxes work, the black and white television, you know, with the dial. So I listen to the radio all the time. And yeah, look at those blueberries. This is a 1966 George Ladd houseboat, and we had it for a long time, and the roof finally went off, so I put this type of roof on it, which the peak roof, which I think looks more Delta than the flat roof, you know, and a tornado come by and rolled this up. Little shop I have to get some work done, because the one thing living out here, you know, you just can't go to Home Depot and pick up anything, so you know, most of the tools you have are pretty well used, or you have to keep them maintained and everything, because you just can't go, like say if you're downtown, and just go and get some. So I have a lot of tools. This I use a lot. I have this right here is a come along, and this right here, you hook here and you hook there, and then you pull it up. You know, pull things up, or stretch things. I have about six of those that I need. I have tools I'm going to have to, I've been threatening to clean up. I have a punching bag that I use for exercise, because I try to do a series of exercises. I think all men become little boys on the dream of being an island or owning an island. And I think all little girls and older women always would like to be on an island that nobody can get to, no one can get to. And once they get that feeling, well then, the island seemed to be theirs, so that if I had a thief or a person causing problems or anything like that, I could always depend upon the responsible people trying to protect their island. So it wasn't just me protecting the island, it was everybody around that found out that they were on an island wasn't going to let their island go bad.
All right, I'm sure you're 21.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Thank you very much for showing me the ID. This is the place to go to have your fun. Make sure you carry a big stick, girl, because you're going to need it. There's animals out here. But where else? Lost Isle, huh? Oh, my God.
Boating, everybody likes boating, and this is the place to boat too.
I've noticed they've made improvements here since I've been coming here, and they cater more to the people here. It's still a little bit wild, which is fun, but most of the people here are pretty cool. I never see fights here in the daytime or anything crazy like that. You know, everything's under control now. That's what I like.
And that's why it's nice having Windmill Cove. And they're doing, Dave's doing a great job cleaning it up, getting rid of dopers, being dependable, really promoting camping and everything. But it's not Lost Isle. It's not, you know, the old man that turns into a little boy on an island, or the middle-aged woman that feels that she'd like to put on a striped bathing suit and swing through the tree. I would say the Lost Isle was noted in Stockton from all over the world, a great place to go. And whether you're in Tahiti or whether you're in Mexico or anything, you found a good old Lost Isle cup hanging around in the bushes somewhere. And people,
for heat people in the wintertime, I have a little potbelly stove. I have a propane refrigerator and stove. I'm just cooking some chicken. I usually buy chicken and I fillet the meat off, and then I boil the bones and the meat and the fat, and then I cook with the fat and then I eat vegetables, you know, cabbage and celery and stuff like that. And I have a bed for one and a third person, so my girlfriend have a place to sleep when she comes out. This right here is my desk, and I have been trying to learn how to play some instruments with a harmonica and play guitar.
Can you play something for us?
Yeah, sure. never made a fortune. I guess it's too late now. It really doesn't matter much. I'm happy anyhow. And as I walk through life, reaping more than I have sown, I'm drinking from a saucer, 'cause my cup has overflown. Ain't got a lot of riches, and sometime the going is rough, but I got a family that loves me, and that makes me rich enough. And I just thank God for the blessings, the mercy He has bestowed. I'm drinking from a saucer, 'cause my cup has overflowed. And sometimes when things go wrong, and my faith gets a little thin, and the old dark clouds gather, then the sun comes out again, I won't gripe about the tough roads I have hoed. I'm drinking from a saucer, 'cause my cup has overflowed. And things go wrong, and my faith gets a little thin, and the old dark sun comes back again, I won't gripe about the tough roads I have hoed. I'm drinking from a saucer, 'cause my cup has overflowed. And if God gives me the strength and the courage when the way gets stiff and rough, I won't ask for other blessings. I've already been blessed enough. And may I never be too busy to help another with his load. I'm drinking from a saucer, 'cause my cup has overflowed. Well, this one first. That was Mary had a little lamb.